Okay, this video will discuss the rational zero theorem. What are zeros? Zeros, another word for zeros, are roots, another word for roots, or zeros are our solutions. The reason why they're called zeros, it goes back to our remainder theorem, it goes back to our factor theorem, is when I plug these values, solutions, these roots, into our function, the result will be zero. Or in other words, when I do my synthetic division or any type of division, my remainder will be zero. So in order to figure out the list of possible rational zeros, so in other words, if I'm wanting to solve my equation, start from scratch, I don't have any hints or ideas as to what would be a solution or not, I can use the rational zero theorem, and which will give me all of the possible rational solutions there are. So you would do plus or minus, and then you would take the factors of your constant and place them over each one of the factors of your leading coefficient. So let's look at the first example. List all possible rational zeros of 15x cubed plus 14x squared minus 3x minus 2. So my constant is 2. My leading coefficient is 15. So the factors of 2 are just 1 times 2. Factors of 15 is 1 times 15 and 3 times 5. So I'm going to take the 1 and the 2 and place them over the 1, 15, 3, and 5. So there's plus or minus 1 over 1, 1 over 15, 1 over 3, 1 over 5. And then 2 over 1, 2 over 15, 2 over 3, and 2 over 5. Simplify your list. And once again, that plus or minus is in front of each one of those numbers. And that will give me 16 possible rational solutions that I could choose from. Looking at the next one, I have 6x to the fourth minus 7x squared plus 5x minus 4. My constant is 4, so my factors of 4 is 1 times 4, 2 times 2. Factors of 6, 1 times 6 and 2 times 3. So I take the 1, 4, and 2 and place them over 1, 6, 2, and 3. So that'll give me the list of 1 over 1, 1 over 6, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 4 over 1, 4 over 6, 4 over 2, 4 over 3, then 2 over 1, 2 over 6, 2 over 2, and then 2 over 3. You don't have to do 2 twice. Then we will simplify our list. Once we simplify our list, we will see that some of them would cancel out. For example, 4 over 2 is 2, 2 over 1 is also 2. So some of our terms will cancel out, and that will give me a list of 16 possible rational solutions once again. And so what we would do here, if we wanted to figure out if either one of these are solutions or not, I would take one, take positive one, plug it into my equation. If I get 0, then that means that's a solution or 0 of the function. If not, then it's not. So I knock out positive 1, then I would try negative 1. Then I would try positive 1/6, then I would try negative 1/6. So I'll keep trying until I get to the end of my list or I get the desired amount of solutions possible. Don't forget, the highest degree of your exponent lets you know how many solutions that there are possibly. So here I should have 4 solutions, even if I have repeated solutions. And then in this top one, I should have 3 solutions, even if there are some repeated solutions. All right, so let me know if you have any questions.